Life is a game. At least that's a good way to see it. And part of the game is to remember that it is a game and to remember the rules of the game. Now, if you don't believe it's a game that's meant to be fun, capital F, capital U, capital N, fun. Just look at how people behave when they first come to planet Earth as little kids. Aren't they just ridiculous? Aren't they a lot of fun? There's no trying to fit in, trying not to rock the boat, trying to adapt. Trying to maintain that veneer of normalcy and adapting to whatever's happening. There's no intellectualizing, no analyzing. They're just having fun all day. They're just being themselves to the point that they're not even thinking about what it means to be themselves. That's because they just came from the other side, and they have a better intuitive memory of what they were told about life on Earth. They were told, go down there and have a blast. Now, as we grow older, our well-meaning but misinformed parents educate us into seriousness. They say, what do you think? Do you think life is a party? Do you think this is some kind of game? Just who do you think you are? Time to get serious. Time to get tough. Time to shoulder the burden. And society uses shame, guilt, fear, anger, and other forms of extreme seriousness to get us to obey and adapt to mediocrity. And that's how we gradually give up the lightness, the exuberance, the sense of adventure and surprise we had as children. And then, as adults, we wonder, where did all the energy go? And once we ourselves get sufficiently serious and dull, we then proceed to make sure others stay in line and remain serious and dull, and obey, and shut up, and follow the rules, and. Now, don't get me wrong. I do not advertise a hedonistic lifestyle. That's not what I'm saying. Nor am I recommending a constant pursuit of pleasure. Ideally, regular days to be spent something like this. Part in work, learning, or creative endeavor, part in caring for friends or family or pets, part in meditation or prayer, contemplation, and part in fun and leisure. The problem is that the majority of society lives something like this. And that is the life balance of a slave. the life balance of a free, civilized, and conscious human being might look something like this. So how's the game of life played? How does it work? Your life is like a TV series or a soap opera. Have you ever noticed the weird soap operas going on in people's lives? When you see the weird soap opera it is, you'll very much enjoy it. Now it's your choice whether the TV show you play in is fun and interesting or sad and depressing. You experience life on a timeline sequentially. First you experience one sequence, then you experience another, and then another, as if spread out on a timeline. But what is actually happening is that the entire supposedly sequential TV series is already finished and complete as a whole package. Okay, when somebody produces a TV show, it's already a whole package, whole and complete, and they sell it to the TV channel. And the TV channel broadcasts it sequentially, episode by episode. And consciousness works in the same way. Because it would be overwhelming to the mind and the nervous system to experience the entire package all at once, it is experienced as if sequence by sequence. But the TV series you're playing in, the movie of your life, is already whole and complete from the very beginning to the final ending. And that's what's called destiny. So where does free will come in? Well, in two different ways. So the difference to a normal TV show that is completely predestined is that you can actually make a few different choices within one show. So that would be as if you're watching a TV show and its makers created multiple different next episodes depending on the choices that you make. Okay, so you got four choices as to which direction the series is going to go, for example. However, within a particular show, within a particular reality, with its accompanying people, profession, free time activities, typical places, ways of dressing, talking, walking, reading, etc., all your choices are limited to the domain or context that you are in. No matter what choices you make within a particular reality or timeline, you'll always end up in similar places. You make good choices, you'll experience the good version of those places. You make bad choices, you'll experience the bad version of those places. But there's not that much overall change. And that's one way you can go through life, and that's fine. That can be good or not. A more radical way to change your reality is to switch the TV series altogether. So rather than making new choices within the existing framework, you shift to another framework. That's like deciding you will no longer watch one TV show, you'll watch another. And what that requires is a shift in your self-definition, your identity, and by extension, your beliefs and the direction of your attention. But first comes a shift in who you think you are, who you define yourself as, and along with that goes a change in your thoughts and what you focus on. So, by merely acting as if you're in another reality for a while, you will gradually shift to another timeline altogether. And that's the process I describe in my book, Parallel Universes of Self. Have you ever noticed how certain people act differently dependent on which other people they are surrounded by? So there might be this athlete who's part of some team and he's not performing very well, and then a new coach comes in, and in the presence of that new coach, this athlete suddenly performs fantastically, like a different person altogether. Why? It's because the framework, the context changed. And what creates the context? It's the identity, the persona, in this example, the presence of that new coach. Or looking at the corporate world, an employee might suddenly blossom under a new boss. What I'm getting at here is that you can become the person around which all of life blossoms. What I'm getting at here is that you can become the person around which all of life blossoms. And that is the art of reality creation, as taught in the reality creation courses. My name is Fred Dodson, and my wish for you is that you have more fun.